first, our the decision and the policy of to dissociate ourselves politically, but it doesn't mean that we are dissociating ourselves from humanitarian aspect. Humanitarian aspect, we are fully involved. We are taking care. Today, we have around 70,000 Syrians registered officially as displaced in Lebanon. We are taking care fully as shelter, medical care, education, all they need, and we are doing this in a very decent, quiet way. So we are not dissociating ourselves from humanitarian. And what will be the other? You are thinking about the trafficking of arms and so on. Yes, true. At the beginning, a few months ago, they used to have a kind of trafficking of arms. And now, today, after the Lebanese army, they are implementing a severe plan at the border, northern border and eastern border of Lebanon. This smuggling and trafficking of people and arms, it's becoming almost inexistent.
You have made some arrests in connection with an alleged Syrian plot to set off bombs in public places in Lebanon. It definitely seems as if the Syrian regime is trying to drag Lebanon into the conflict. So, I mean, clearly, if they're violating your borders, I mean, this must be a problem between you and Syria.
If you followed our position after this plot, we mentioned also we dissociate ourselves from interfering in Syria, but this doesn't mean at all that we accept that the Syrians will interfere in our political affair and they will do such plot. So also we are saying discriminate, they dissociate ourselves from interfering in Syria, but since Syria they are interfering in Lebanese domestic affair, we had a very severe position from the President of the Republic and from the government and from myself.
So you say that they are trying to interfere in your affairs. Is your government trying to reassess its relationship with the Syrian regime right now? Are you disassociating yourself from the regime now?
No, we are saying, please, we don't want to interfere. It's not our decision if we would like to keep the regime or to withdraw the regime or to collapse. We cannot do anything. Don't ask from Lebanon things that they are beyond our capability to do. Don't forget we have a society completely divided. We have a society divided. So this will also, any position we would take, it will reflect on our society. For this reason, we dissociate ourselves because to maintain the unity of our society. We would not like to interfere in other internal affairs.
Let me ask you about Israel and its threats to Iran's nuclear program. I mean, there are clearly fears that Israel could bomb Iran, and then Hezbollah would, in fact, as a proxy of Iran, perhaps respond. Are you afraid that this could drag Lebanon into this conflict?
I believe the spirit of responsibility at Hezbollah and all Lebanese parties, they understand this. For this reason, at the dialogue table in Baabda, we issued a Baabda Pact in last July, saying this Baabda Pact, out of 17 points, that no single Lebanese will defend any third party other than Lebanon. So for this reason...
Do you think Hezbollah will abide to that?
I believe they know, they have the sense of responsibility, and they will take this into consideration differently.
I want to ask you about this recent Arab-American protest, not just in Lebanon, but throughout the region, because of this video decrying the Prophet Muhammad. Do you think this is about the Prophet, or do you think this is about a wider resentment of U.S.
in
the region?
Whatever is because, but I can say we condemn any violence and any violence for any reaction will happen, either from this side or this side. We have to understand the other, we have to be tolerant, but at the same time, we should not accept such films to hurt, let's say, the feeling of billions of Muslims around the world.